ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ नमः पाणिनिकात्यायन पतञ्जलिभ्यः शब्दविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो मुनिभ्यो गुरुभ्यः नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द 60th क्लास टुडे 3rd May 2013 वी हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड 59 क्लासेस ऑफ द संस्कृत फॉर द बिगिनर्स इन द प्रीवियस क्लास इफ यू रिमेंबर वी स्टडीड वी हैव बीन स्टडीइंग इन फैक्ट द 6th केस षष्ठी विभक्ति एंड वी हैव सीन ऑल द नंबर्स इन षष्ठी विभक्ति singular, dual, plural, ekavachana, divachana, bahuvachana. And in the previous class, immediate previous class, day before yesterday, we studied tat pronoun, the demonstrative pronoun. So two were finished in sixth case, in genitive case or possessive case. And we also took up, studied one personal pronoun, that was yushmat. In sixth case, in the Shasti Vibhakti, Yushmat was studied. Today we are going to read and practice the Asmat in Shasti Vibhakti. Mama Avayoho Asmakam. That is the derivation. And we are actually on page 376, Bhargav, you can show them. 228, lesson number 228. And 376 is the page number where we are going to practice, do the practice of Mama Avayoho Asmakam. This is the personal pronoun number 2, which is I pronoun. We have seen the you pronoun in the previous class. So going there, now five sentences are divided here. Five sentences for singular practice, five sentences for dual practice, Dvivachana practice, and five for plural Bahuvachana practice. Altogether, you find 15 sentences on this page. And in each five sentences, each set of five sentences, the first one is given as a clue to follow in the same manner. So what is the first sentence? Here we go. It reads, Aham Chhatraha. Now here also, the auxiliary verb, I am a student, I am is understood. Asmi is understood, as I have told you in the previous class also. Asti is mostly understood. Saha Rameshaha. Asti implied. He is Ramesh, Mr. Ramesh. Now coming to this personal pronoun I here, Aham Chhatraha. Somebody is saying Aham Chhatra. I am a student. In English we require four words to translate this. Aham Chhatraha. If you translate literally, I student. I student, it can't be done like this. Aham Chhatraha, what is understood is Asmi. I am a student. You require an auxiliary verb, you require article also. I am a student, so that is it. So this is how it is a very condensed, precise language. Meaning is all the same. Aham Chhatraha, this is close to English. Mama is very close to English. What is English? My. English is my. Mama nama, if you say my name. Mama deshaha, my country. Mama bandhuhu, my relative. So mama means my. It is very close to English. So aham is I and mama is my, relating to me. Mama nama rameshaha. He says my name is Ramesh. You can say anything now. Mama nama bhargavaha. Mama nama Sureshaha, Mama nama, and so on and so forth. So this aham, which is prathama ekavachana. What is aham? Aham is the first case. Mama is the sixth case, shasti ekavachana. Second sentence. What is that second sentence? Aham vaidyaha. Very simple. You can also try. Aham vaidya. I am a doctor. I am a physician. I am a physician. Mama karyam rugna seva. My job is serving to the diseased. Serving the patients. Rugna seva. Rugna means diseased. sick people. So mama karyam, my job, rugna seva asti, there also asti is implied, is my job is to serve the sick people. Mama, my. So mama immediately understand as my. Third one, aham chhatra, some girl is saying, I am a girl student. Mama nama, even she says, mama nama Vinodini, my name is Vinodini. Then the fourth one, aham adhyapika, I am a lady teacher here. If the word were to be adhyapakaha, it is a male teacher. Since it is adhyapika, ending in akaranta, you know by now. All the viewers should also know that. This is a feminine noun, therefore I am a lady teacher. Mama karyam sikshanam, my job is teaching. Sikshanam is teaching. Mama karyam, my job, my work. Otherwise, sikshanam is teaching. So this is how simple way you understand how this aham personal pronoun I gets derived in the singular as mama, mama, mama. So we say in our culture, in Indian culture, if you develop more of this more of this consciousness, mama, mama, my, this is my house, this is my child, this is my wife, it is called mamakara. If you develop more of mama, it develops into mamakara, attachment, minus, we call it minus. That minus should be minus. Okay, fifth sentence, finishing this singulars, aham rameshasya mitram, very simple, I am a friend of Ramesh. And here mama nama panchananam, panchanana, sorry, mama nama panchanana, some name, panchanana. Panchanana doesn't mean the person who has five heads here, some name here. So this is how these four, five sentences we have practiced, seen how this aham is to be converted in sixth, derived in shasti vibhakti, in the possessive case, genitive case, as mama, mama, mama. Now we are going to see the dual number of the same. How does the aham change into dual? Aham, avam, you can see the down in the vertical way. Aham, 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 five times repeated. Now sixth one is beginning with avam, we both. Avam means we two. Aham, myself, singular. Avam, we both. Vayam means we. Vayam is plural. So we are dual, practicing vivachana now. Avam, yes. Avam balakau, very simple statement. Avam balakau, we both are students, I mean sir, boys. We both are boys. Avayoho mitram narendraha. The next half says avayoho. This avam, prathama dvivachana, nominative dual number, is derived in sixth case dual number is avayoho, our. This our is not plural, of both of us. Avayoho mitram, who is he? Narendra. Narendra is a friend of both of us. Here avayoho is specifically of two of us. Mama is my, ekavachana, singular, there is no doubt. But avayoho, since Sanskrit alone has in the world languages now this dual number, the purpose also I have told you, to be very specific, there are so many pairs in nature. There are so many things which go in pairs, and that is why the Sanskrit developed this number and it retains till date. Because to be very precise, avayoho only refers to of both of us. When you cross a dvivachana, it is plural in Sanskrit. Whereas in all other languages, including our Indian languages, we have ekavachana and bahuvachana. We do not have dvivachana, number two. Dual number is not there. So, seventh sentence. Avam balike. Simple. We both are girls. How many girls? We are two girls. We both are girls. Okay. Avayoho, our. Our in dual number. Sikshika Surekha. Surekha is the teacher of both of us. Is our teacher, in sense both of us, is the teacher of both. Avayoho is repeated here again. Eighth one, Avam Rajakau. Some person is saying, Rajaka means a washerman. Washerman. Avam Rajakau. We both are washermen. Avayoho karyam, our job, Vastra Prakshalanam. Prakshalanam. Our job, our work is washing clothes. Rajakaha means washerman. Now, in India, we still have these people. We can't do away, yes. They have their own business and they are great in demand also. They wash and also they iron the clothes. But unlike in the Western countries, you don't find, I don't think we will find Rajakas or washermen, because machines have taken over. So machine washing is mostly done there. So Avam Rajako, we both are washermen. Avam Avayoho Karyam, our job, Vastra Prakshalanam, washing clothes. Ninth one, Avam Gruhinyam. So you watch here, we are deriving masculine noun, feminine noun, any noun can come with this personal pronouns Avam. Because the speaker can be masculine, the speaker can be a feminine person, the speaker can also be an inanimate thing, like a machine can speak. So the Avam doesn't undergo change here. That is what you bear in mind. Avam Gruhinyam. What does this mean? We both are housewives. We are two housewives. Avayoho, again you repeat, Avayoho Gruham Nagare Asti. Our house, our home is in the city. Avayoho Gruham, our home, Nagare Asti. This Nagare is in 6th, 7th case, which we are going to read shortly, very soon. This is the 7th case, locative case. It is called locative, 7th case, location. So where is our house? Kutra Avayoho Gruham Asti. Avayoho Gruham Nagare Asti. Nagare, in the city. We are housewives, both. Our home is in the city. That is the meaning of 9th sentence. Nagare, not A comes, Nagare, Grame. So we will take up immediately after 2-3 pages. Saptami is coming. It is coming after in 382 page. We are going to study that. We are going to come across. Now with the Saptami, the noun study becomes complete. So Nagare, in the city. Hyderabad Nagare, if you say in New York Nagare, in the city of New York. Mumbai Nagare, in the city of Mumbai. Anywhere you can attach in Nagare. Tenth one. Avam Mitre. Avam Mitre. This Mitra Shabda is Napumsaka. Therefore it is derived according to Mitram, Mitre, Mitrani. So Avam, we both are Mitre, friends. We both are friends. Avayoho Vidyalaya Uttamaha. Our school is the best. Now this is how, what we have learned in these 5 sentences, how this Avam, we both, is to be derived in 6th case dual number Avayoho. Avam becomes Avayoho. Aham becomes Mama in the 6th. So Aham, Mama, Avayoho, Avam, Avayoho, and we are going to plurals now. From 11th to 15th plural practice is there. Now what is the 11th sentence? Vayam Adhyapaka. Anybody can understand. Even a person who has very little knowledge of Sanskrit can understand. Vayam Adhyapaka. We are teachers. Aham Adhyapaka. I am deriving all from the singular. Aham Adhyapaka. I am a teacher. Avam Adhyapakau. We both are teachers. Vayam Adhyapaka. We are teachers. Okay, now this Vayam, which is plural in the first case, nominative case, is derived in the plural 6th case, Asmakam, our. In English it is OU or our. Of both of us I said in the dual number. My Mama is very clear, my. There is no my. Mama Gruham, Mama Nama, etc. Asmakam should be understood as our. So Asmakam Dharmaha Adhyapanam. our duty here, dharma means duty, our duty is teaching. Adhyapanam, patanam, sikshanam, these are the words used for teaching. Adhyapanam, teaching. Asmakam dharmaha, our duty, adhyapanam, teaching. So what is implied here in this sentence also is understood. Asmakam dharmaha adhyapanam asti. Asti is implied. We take it for granted, it is there. What is the 12th? Can you read, Bhargav? Try. You are a new student. Yes. Dharmacharyaha. Vayam dharmacharyaha. We are religious teachers. We are religious teachers. Asmakam lakshyam. Asmakam lakshyam. Our goal, our aim. Dharma sikshanam. Teaching of dharma. That is religion. Vayam dharma acharyaha. Sandhi is there. Dharma acharyaha. We are religious teachers. Our aim is to teach about religion. Dharma sikshanam. Religion teaching. Vayam chhatraha. The next, yeah, very simple. Like in the previous page, in the, I think the first sentence is that. Aham chhatraha. It opens with aham chhatraha. I am a student. Here, plural of it. Vayam chhatraha. We are students. Asmakam karyam adhyayanam. Our job is study. Our job is to study, is study, or studying is our job. Adhyayanam, now look at these two words. Adhyayanam means study, studying. Adhyapanam is teaching. Both words are like that. Like we have patanam, reading. Patanam, again teaching. So causal way, sorry. 14th sentence we have to see. Vayam. Mala karyaha. We are flower weavers, lady flower weavers. Mala kari, the shabda is here, the noun is mala kari. Mala kara, we also have a masculine word in the same sense. A male person who weaves garlands, garland weaver, garland maker, otherwise what to say, is called mala karaha akaranta. Malakari, here is feminine noun. So derive it in plural, malakari, malakaryav, malakaryaha. So that is how it is. It is like nadi, what we studied earlier. Malakari, malakaryav, malakaryaha. The first in case is like this, malakari. Show them this. This is like nadi only. Like nadi. Then come to the page now. Vayam malakaryaha. We are garland weavers. Garland weavers. Asmakam karyam. Asmakam karyam. What is our job? Mala vikrayanam. Mala vikrayanam. Our job is to sell garlands. Selling garlands. So in other words, we say we are florists. Florists, lady florists. Our job is to sell flowers. Asmakam karyam. Mala vikrayanam. Mala is garland. Vikrayanam is selling. Selling of garlands is our job. And the last sentence in this page where we are finishing with the practice of personal pronoun aham and its derivation, sixth case, vayam mitrani. Now this mitrani is plural. You know that, you should remember mitram, mitre, mitrani. That is aham, avam, vayam is plural. Vayam mitrani, we are friends. Asmakam maitri pragadha. Asmakam maitri pragadha means our friendship is deep. Deep rooted is not best here. Pragada means very, very fast friendship. It is very deep friendship. Pragada, very. So our friendship is very deep. Vayam mitrani, Asmakam Maitri Pragadha. So this is how we have seen 15 sentences of Shasti Vibhakti in the with the pronoun, personal pronoun Aham here. And we move on, some more 2-3 pages are devoted for practice of the Shasti Vibhakti still. And then we go to the Saptami as I was just mentioning. Now Abhyasa 229 here on the page 377. What you are supposed to, whatever is studied now so far in this class and on the previous class, in the previous class, you have to recall and use them here. Some places they have given you the clues here. Now can you read, try reading Bhargav? Avam Chhatrau, you know, Avam Chhatrau should mean, you should be able to translate it as we both are students. Avam, since Avam is immediately we are coming from the same pronoun. Avam Chhatrau, we both are students. So Avayoho, dual number, Avayoho Karyam Adhenam, our job is study. Our job is to study. Second one. Eshaha Balakaha. Now Eshaha is a pronoun here, demonstrative pronoun which we studied in the previous class. And you put that Eshaha in sixth case, possessive case. And how it derives in the sixth case is Etasya. Eshaha becomes Etasya. Eshaha Balakaha, when I say this is a boy. This is a boy. Etasya, this person's Nama. What is that? Sudevaha. His name, this person's name is Sudev. Okay? Etasya. Etat is used when a person is at your, close to you. Close to you. Close to you. Etat. Eshaha. When I point out to person. Saha is, we opened this book with that only. You have to recall all learners and viewers. Saha means he. Eshaha means this person. These are two opposite pronouns. So, Eshaha Balakaha, this is a boy. Etasya Nama Sudevaha, his name is
Sudev.
Sudev. Or the name of this boy is Sudev. That way also you can understand. Third one, Te Adhyapakaha. Now, Te is a pronoun here. What is the pronoun? Saha Tau Te. Saha plural Te. They are Adhyapakaha, teachers. They are teachers. So here you have to use the plural of te in sixth case. Te sham, already given for you. Te sham jnanam atyadhikam. They have lot of knowledge. Te sham jnanam atyadhikam asti. They have lot of knowledge. They have more knowledge since they are teachers. Te adhyapakaha. Tesham jnanam atyadhikam. They have more knowledge. Here, tesham is to be understood in the sense of possessing. They have one way of understanding. They have more knowledge. Tesham jnanam atyadhikam asti. Another way of understanding in English is their knowledge is more. Tesham jnanam atyadhikam. Their knowledge is more. Or it means, or we can understand, they have more knowledge. One is possessive, another is relation, showing relation. Their relation. Fourth one, te balike. Now, be careful here. Te adhyapakaha. Te is plural there and masculine pronoun. Now, coming down there, te balike. This is not plural. Since it comes, I have shown you, and the book also has shown you several times, te comes in the dual number in feminine gender, strilinga and also napumsakalinga. But when te comes, when te is used followed by a masculine noun, it is plural. When te is followed by a feminine noun, it is dual number. Now, balike is the clue here. If balike was not given, if balike word were not given here, then we cannot know whether te is plural or te is dual. We cannot decide. It should be followed by some noun. So te balike very clear there. Those two are girls. Now, Since this is a feminine pronoun te, you have to use tayoho. Tayoho, what is following? Pariksha phalam samichinam. Their result is very good. Tayoho, which is commonly used for, tayoho is common for masculine and feminine and also neuter. Tayoho. This is studied in the previous lesson. I will just tell you. We studied just two pages before it came. 373 page. Tayoho practice came. Three seventy-four also. You can show them 374 just for a while. Tayoho feminine practice is there. Page 373 is masculine, 74 is feminine practice. Tayoho is there na? Tasyaha tayoho tasam. That is it. But I think our viewers cannot go to previous pages. Ne? They have to go to a video to see. They have to go to the previous video to see this. Okay. Which sentence now? Fifth. Taha. This is again feminine pronoun. Mahilaha. They are women. They are women. They are women. R is understood. Taha mahilaha. Now, sixth case of taha, as we have seen in the previous class, I mean previous page only, 374, once again, Bhargava can show them. Tasam is derived as tasam. Then, two pages go back. 226 lesson number. So here they have to see the sentence number 13. Taha is becoming tasam. So come back now. So fifth sentence here is taha mahilaha. They are women, ladies. Tasam, since vriddhau is a, eto is masculine, no doubt about it, vriddhau is also. So these two are old men. Eto vriddhau means these two are old men. Now what is the shasti of eto? We have to again recall your previous exercises. Etayoho, tayoho becomes etayoho, these two peoples. Etayoho sevam karotu. Do the service of these two old men. Etayoho sevam kurvantu. Afterwards, I will write all these answers for them. We will orally do now and then. Seventh one. Tvam yuvakaha. We just studied tvam in the immediate previous class. Today we studied aham. Tvam yuvakaha. You are a young man. You are a youth. Tvam yuvakaha. So how does tvam derives in sixth case? Tava. So you say tava dharmaha rashtra seva. Your duty is to serve the country. National service. Rashtra seva means national service. Your duty is to serve the country. Rashtra raksha seva is there. Correct. Next one. Vayam sainikaha. Now from aham we have come to plural. Vayam, we. Sainikaha, we are soldiers. Vayam sainikaha. Then vayam in sixth case derives as asmakam, our. Asmakam dharmaha, our duty. Rashtra raksha. Here rashtra in Sanskrit stands for country, desha. It should not be confused for any other regional sense. In regional language, we sometimes understand it as a state, Rashtra Bhasha. Rashtra Bhasha in Hindi and Sanskrit means national language. But in regional languages in India, sometimes it has a sense of a local state. It is not state but country. So asmakam dharmaha rashtra raksha. What is our, we are soldiers, our duty is the protection of the country.
Rashtra sounds in like Telugu.
In Telugu it is misunderstood. What is understood in Sanskrit is rashtra means country. Rashtra seva, rashtra raksha. Our dharma, our duty is to protect the country, country protection. So that is 8th one. 9th one, yuvam antariksha yatrikau. Yuvam, this is pronoun you, tvam yuvam, you both. You both are antariksha yatrikau, you both are astronauts. You both are astronauts. Then yuvayoho, this yuvam derives in shasti, sixth case, yuvayoho, your karyam, job, antariksha yatra, your job is traveling in the space, travel in the space. 10th one, um plural, vaimanikaha, um, what is um plural of tvam, tvam, yuvam, um, that is the derivation, um vaimanikaha, you all are, what do you call, vaimanikaha, pilots, you are all pilots, yushmakam karyam, now the derivation of 6th of this is yushmakam, karyam, job, vimana chalanam, your job is piloting the aeroplane, driving the aeroplane. Vimana chalanam, chalanam means driving. So you are all, what you said, pilots, your job is to fly the aircraft, vimana chalanam. 11th one, saha arakshakaha, tat pronoun, saha, he is a cop, is a policeman, arakshakaha. Now saha becomes in shashti vibhakti, tasya, tasya dharmaha, what is his dharmaha, anushasana raksha, his job is protecting the law, protecting the discipline, protecting the law and order in the society. So saha arakshaka is a cop, tasya dharmaha, his job, duty, his duty, anushasana raksha, his duty is to protect the discipline in the society. That is 11. 12th one, esha lata, this pronoun, etat pronoun, esha lata, this is a girl or a lady by name lata. Then esha becomes etasyaha. Oh, this is a creeper only here. Sometimes we got confused in the previous pages also. Lata is given for, even in India, we have Lata given, a name given to women also. Lata means a creeper. Here it is used in the sense of creeper. Esha Lata, this is a creeper, not a woman, but women also are given Lata. So many Swarna Lata, Sita Lata, so many names are there. So esha lata, this is a creeper, etasyaha pushpani sundarani, the flowers of this creeper are beautiful. Etasyaha, of this creepers, pushpani sundarani are very beautiful. Now 13th one reads, tau jeshthau, they both are elders, older people or elder people. Tau jeshtau, those two are elderly people. Now tayoho, it derives as tayoho adesham palayatu, you follow their order, instruction. Tayoho adesham palayatu, you should follow their order. 14, sa buddhimati, sa buddhimati, she is a very intelligent lady. Sa is she, sa buddhimati nari kanya, whoever it is, she is an intelligent woman. Then tasyaha sahayam svikarotu, tasyaha, it becomes tasyaha sahayam svikarotu, take her help. She is intelligent, take her help, tasyaha sahayam svikarotu. Next, 15. Tat pushpam, very simple. Tat pushpam, that's a flower. That is a flower. Tasya sugandha ahladakaraha. Tasya sugandha ahladakaraha. Its sugandha means fragrance. Its smell or fragrance is ahladakara, is joyful. Tat pushpam, it's a flower. Tasya sugandha, its fragrance. Ahladakar is very delighting, is delightful. Next, 16th, tani vahanani. Now, neuter pronoun practice here. Tatte tani, vahanam vahane vahanan, neuter noun and neuter pronoun. Tani vahanani, how do you understand? Those are the vehicles. They are the vehicles. Those are the vehicles. Now, in Shasti, tesham akaram pashyatu. Where are we? I'm missing. No. Tesham vegaha mahan. Tani vahanani, they are vehicles. Tesham vegaha mahan. Their speed is great. They have a great speed. You can understand in two ways. They have great speed or their speed is great. sorry. Next, 16. Over. 17. Aham Abhimanyuhu. Somebody is saying, Aham Abhimanyuhu. I am a person by name Abhimanyu. Mama Mata Uttara. Mama Mata Uttara. My mother is Uttara. This is the same character from Mahabharata, Abhimanyu. 18th. Etat Palam. This is a fruit. Etat Palam. Tat Pushpam we studied. Opposite Etat Palam. This is a fruit. Etasya Akaram Pashyatu. See the shape of this fruit. Etasya Akaram Pashyatu. Then 19th one. Etani Gruhani. These are homes. These are homes. Etesham. Now here the practice is Etat. Etani Gruhani. Etesham Aunnatyam Bahu Asti. Their Aunnatyam. Their height is, they have a great height. Etani Gruhani, first statement, these are homes. Etesham Aunnatyam Bahu Asti, they have a big height. They have a good height. Then 20th, Vayam Bharatiyaha, finally. We are Indians. Asmakam Deshaha Bharata Deshaha. Our country is India. Bharat. Vayam Bharatiya. If you convert this into singular, Aham Bharatiyaha. Mama Deshaha Bharata Deshaha. If you convert into dual number, Aham Avam Bharatiyau. We both are Indians. Avayoho Deshaha Bharata Deshaha. This is how you practice. Now I may write for the sake of the learners and the answers which are not given. You tell me the numbers, I will hold the book and fast write it. The answers which are there already, I will not write. Only first one is there, third one is there, and the remaining have to be written. I am writing from the second one onwards. Second answer is Eshaha Etasya. Etasya Nama, etc. Third one is given. Fourth one I am writing Te Balike Tayoho. Tayoho. Pariksha, etc., etc. To be understood. Then the fifth one, Taha Mahilaha Tasam. Taha Mahilaha Tasam. And followed by Sammanam Kurvantu. Sixth one, Etau Vruddhau Etayoho. Etayoho. What is following? Etau Vruddhau Sevam Karotu. those things are there. Seventh one, Tvam Yuvakaha, Tava, Tava, etc. And then eighth one, Vayam Sainikaha Asmakam, Asmakam Dharmaha follows. Ninth one, Yuvam Antariksha Yatrikau, Yuvayoho, it is Yuvayoho, and follows. Tenth one, Yuyam Vaimanikaha, Yuyam Yushmakam, Yushmakam follows. And the 11th one, Saha Arakshakaha Tasya, Tasya Dharmaha, Karyam, whatever it is, follows. Then the 12th one I am writing here, Esha Lata Etasyaha, Etasyaha follows. 13, Tau Jeshthau Tayoho, Tayoho Adisham, whatever it is, Palayatu. 14th, Sa Buddhimati Tasyaha, Tasyaha Sahayam Svikarotu, whatever it is. 15, Tat Pushpam Tasya, Tasya Sugandaha, etc. Two words follow. 16th one, Tani Vahanani, Tani Vahanani, Tesham, Tesham Vegaha, etc. 17th one, Aham Abhimanyuhu, Mama Mata, Aham becomes Mama Mata, Uttara. 18th one, Etat Palam, Etasya, Etasya Akaram Pashyatu follows. 19th one, Etani Gruhani, Etayoho, Etesham, sorry, Etesham Aunatyam, Etesham Etesham Aunatyam Bahu Asti. 20th, Vayam Bharatiyaha Asmakam, Asmakam Deshaha Bharata Deshaha. So these are the answers here. So rapidly read them, borrow just answers. One is already there, two is Etasya, fourth is Tesham, fifth is Tasam, yeah, fifth is Tasam, sixth is, what is sixth? Etayoho. Seventh is Tava, eighth is Asmakam, ninth is Yuvayoho, tenth is Tasya, Esha Etasyaha, 13 Tayoho, 14th Tasyaha, right? Tasyaha, 15th Tasya, 16th Tesham, 17th Mama, 18th Etasya, 19th Etesham, 20th Asmakam. That's it. These are the answers. So with this we have finished today, in today's class, the derivation of Aham, Asmad in 6th case, and a practice also, followed by practice. We are going over to the next page. Conveniently, the Abhyasa is not changed. 229 Abhyasa is continued here. And in relation to the 6th case, Shasti Vibhakti, there are some words used. Now that is going to be used, introduced here in these two pages, following pages. 378, 379 are devoted for teaching you what are the words which go with Shasti Vibhakti, with the possessive or genitive case. Now you see with the help of the picture here, show them the picture, Bhargav. Yes. There are so many words introduced here and described down there. Now in the middle there is a mountain, there is a building, there is a tree, okay? And the building is Vidyalaya, the building is school. So what is behind the school, what is beside the school, what is in front of the school, what is to the right of the school, what is to the left of the school, are all put in relation to the Shashti Vibhakti. Therefore, you can look down, the word Vidyalaya is given in Shashti Vibhakti everywhere. Vidyalayasya, 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 Vidyalayasya. And followed by the direction. Vidyalaya, Vidyalayasya Purataha, in front of the school. Vidyalayasya Vamataha, to the left of the school. Vidyalayasya Dakshinataha, to the right of the school. Vidyalayasya, Vidyalayasya Prushtataha, back of the school. So this is how in Sanskrit all directions are shown in relation to the sixth case. So you say, when you describe a house, mama gruham, mama gruhasya purataha, in front of my house, udyanam asti, there is a garden. Or mama gruhasya purataha, vidyalaya asti, in front of my home, there is a school, something like that. So you watch the words here, I'll explain. Upari, upari also means, upari means up, above. Upari is a word showing upper. Upper, in Hindi we say upper, upper in English, upper means above. And prushtataha means back, back of. Dakshinataha means to the right. If you try to understand, the building is situated like this, to the right of the building, to the left of the building, etc. Upari is up, vamataha to the left, purataha in the front. So there are five sentences here, we'll read and try to understand. Vidyalayasya purataha chhatraha santi. Purataha means in front. There are students in front of the school. There are some students in front of the school. Vidyalayasya purataha. Like if I say mama, look here, mama purataha tvam asi. You are there before me. Mama purataha. I can use here. Mama purataha bhargavaha asti. There is bhargava in front of me. Okay. Mama vamataha palakam asti. Shweta palakam asti. To my left is the white board, not blackboard. Mama vamataha krishna palakam vise, but shweta palakam asti. Mama dakshinataha dwaramasti. To my right there is a door, like that. Mama prushtataha Adi Shankaracharyasya chitramasti. Mama prushtataha, behind me there is a portrait of Adi Shankara. So that way you understand. Vidyalayasya purataha chhatraha santi. In front of the school there are students in front of the school, right? Next, vidyalayasya prushtataha parvataha asti. There is a mountain in the back of the school. Prushtataha, as I just told you, back, in my back. Prushtataha, my back. Vidyalayasya prushtataha parvataha asti. There is a mountain in the back of the, to the back of the school. Vidyalayasya vamataha, to the left of the school, there is a garden, udyanam. Where is garden? Yeah. Not seen? In the picture, garden is not there. Ah, is there. Vamataha. Vamataha, there is a garden show. So there is a garden to the left of the school. Vidyalayasya dakshinataha vrikshaha santi. There are trees to the right of the school. There are trees to the right side of the school. Finally, vidyalayasya upari jalagara asti. There is a tank, water tank, above the school, on the school, above the school. So all directions are covered. Up, you can, if you want, if there is something below also, you can say vidyalayasya adaha, below the school. There is a treasury, something like that, you can say. So all directions govern, they demand the noun in the sixth case. That is why this is introduced here. So you can see the direction, show them the direction on the top of the page. This one. Purataha, Prushtataha, Vamataha, Dakshinataha, Upariti Shabdanam Parichaya. So you are introduced here to these words. Purataha front, Prushtataha back, Vamataha left, Dakshinataha to the right, Upari to the above. All these words, when they are used, they must be used with the nouns or pronouns in the nouns in the sixth case only. That is the purpose. Next, we go to the Abhyasa 230 on page 379. Now, whatever you have seen in this picture, you are practicing here. Now practice. One sentence is done again. 15 sentences are provided here. Gruham, Gruhasya. Now, the word given in the bracket here should be used in Shashti Vibhakti. Remember, okay? Gruham should be used as Gruhasya. It is already done for you. Gruhasya Purataha Udyanam Asti. So, what is there? Gruhasya Purataha. There is a garden in front of the house. Next, Udyanam. Udyanasya Purataha Margaha Asti. There is a way in front of the garden. Shivaha. Shivasya Purataha Nandi Vigraha Asti. Shivaha. Shivasya Purataha. You know, in every temple, Shiv temple, in Lord Shiva's temple in India, there is a Nandi, there is a, calf in front of the Shiva's temple. So, Shivasya Purataha, Nandi Vigraha, there is a statue of this Nandi, Asti, there is. Bhavanasya Purataha, Mukhya Dwaram Asti. Bhavanasya Purataha, in front of every house, building, Mukhya Dwaram, main door is there. There is a main door in front of a building. So, Karyalayasya Purataha Yanani Tishtanti. Like in any office, right before the office, vehicles are parked. So, Karyalayasya Purataha Vahanani Tishtanti or Yanani Tishtanti. Yanani, Vahanani, both are same. So, this is how all these five words which are given, Gruham, Udyanam, Karyalayaha, Shiva, are to be put in Shasti when they are to be used with the word Purataha in front of. Now, same practice with the five more sentences. Mandiram, Mandirasya Prushtataha. Now, the word has changed here. Prushtataha, back. What is there in the back of the temple? In India, we have so many wells. Even as on date, although the wells are outdated to some extent, bore wells are there. But if you go to villages, the scene may not have changed there. Still, wells are there, well. That is called Kupaha. So, Gruhasya Prushtataha Kupaha. See, there is a well behind the house. Eighth one. Utpitika Prushtataha. So, Utpitika is Akaranta Strilinga Shabda. Utpitikayaha Shasti. Utpitikayaha Prushtataha Asandaha Asti. There is a chair behind the table. What is Utpitika? We have come across already, long back, studied. Table. This is a table. Esha Utpitika. Utpitikayaha Prushtataha Asandaha Asti. There is a chair behind the table. So derive Utpitika by adding Yaha. Utpitika, same Yaha. Prushtataha Asandaha Asti. Ninth one, Bhavanasya Prushtataha, behind the building, Sasyani Santi, crops are there. There are crops behind the building. Vidyalayasya Prushtataha, behind the school, Kridanganam Asti, there is a playground. There is a playground behind the school. So this is how you understand Prushtataha, Purataha, Purataha in front of, Prushtataha in the back. And now Upari, above. Upper, we'll see that. How much time? 1 minute. We can finish. So, in the five sentences, we'll finish and stop for today. Bhavanam becomes Bhavanasya Upari, above the building. Kimasti Jalagaram Asti. There is a tank. There is a tank above the building. Jalagarasya upari kakaha asti. There is a kakaha, there is a crow on the tank. When there is a water tank, naturally a crow. Jalagarasya upari kakaha asti. There is a crow on the tank, above the tank. 13. Utpitikayaha upari pustakam asti. There is a book on the table, above the table, upari, on the table. Utpitikayaha, again utpitika has come for the second time. Utpitikayaha upari pustakam asti. There is a book on the, above the table. 14. Sanchika means bag. Sanchikayaha, put it in 6th. Sanchikayaha upari nama likitam asti. There is a name mentioned over, above the, on the bag. Over the bank. Bag, sorry, over the bag. There is a name written over the bag. So upari, you understand above, over in those senses. And finally, deepasya upari kitaha bhramati. Now this is typically what you say, rural picture. If there is a deepa, lamp burning, it attracts some insects, brahma. So deepasya upari kitaha, an insect is there over the deepa. So this is how we have done the practice of these words, purataha, prastataha, upari, etc. Adaha is also is used. I think it is coming next, in the next adaha. Not, we will see later. So, shubham bhuyat.